Hey VC friends,
hope you're doing great. Reza is here.
In this tutorial, I'll quickly talk about the conveyor utilities. If we go under conveyors folder, then there is, for example, the basic conveyor. And let me also bring in the feeder quickly. So if I bring this guy and connect it. So when a product is passing over the conveyor, that means that parts are entering the path in this component, this one. And right now, nothing happens. Well, the part is just being navigated through the production line. But using these facilities that I'm going to show you, or these utilities, let's say it's a better word for it, you can actually extend the usability of the conveyor. For example, if I bring in bladder stopper, that starts to stop parts basically. So while it's chosen, you can see also the stopper length, height, and other properties over here. And you can put some kind of delay there and say also what is the task. Look here. What to do when we stop them. There is also possibility to do PLC control with this bladder stopper. How awesome is that, right? There are so many capabilities under these components that you can attach to conveyor and use those. So please go around and explore them more. What else do we have here? There is also this statistics folder. If I scroll down, this is statistics folder. This is also possible to be used with conveyors, and then you can get statistical data. So they are like processors that will be attached on the conveyor. And there is also, for example, this PM flow components that they can also, some of them actually can be attached on a conveyor. For example, the feeder process and then the transport node, they can be attached on a conveyor. But of course, for these guys, we advise to attach one on each conveyor, not many of them. But there is also a way to read how these components work. For example, if I go back to conveyor utilities and on bladder stopper, right click, view metadata. So you see on the description, we have put what does this component do, how to use it, and then what are the key properties. Usually I just copy this and take it to a Word file to read it through. And this applies to a lot of the components in the ECAD, so feel free always to check metadata. But yeah, this is an introduction to conveyor utilities. I'll go through them more in part 2 video. Have a great one and see ya!